Rip currents are a common threat to swimmers along the Central Florida coastline, but lifeguards say there are ways to avoid the grip of a rip.
When the summer season heats up, beachgoers hit the water. That's also when stirred surf poses the biggest rip current threat. They're dangerous, even to strong swimmers.
Well, I train a lot of athletes here, and we run in the water. What's happening is we're running through the holes and keep sucking us out to where we can't really touch.
Lifeguards say rip currents are the reason for most of their rescues. The currents form when storms offshore heighten the sea and create a break in the sandbar. They range in size and force, but Volusia County Beach Patrol officers say there are subtle markers to help spot the rips.
A little choppier in the area, and also it's a little browner because it's pulling sand up from the bottom because it's basically fighting nature. You know, the waves are coming in, but this current's pulling out. So you'll see that it's a little browner in the area, and you'll see the rip current fairly visibly.
Beach Patrol Director Kevin Sweat says swimming near and even talking to a lifeguard is key to avoiding these powerful pulls. So is paying attention to posted signs and flags. A yellow flag signals a heightened rip current threat. It's traded for a red flag when the rips are really dangerous. And if swimmers do get caught up in a strong current?
Well, the best thing to do is not panic with the rip. Most people tend to get, you know, very nervous and upset because, you know, you can start in waist-deep water and get pulled out over your head. The best thing to do is don't try to fight it and come straight back into shore. Try to go parallel to the beach and swim to the north or south.
Lifeguards say if swimmers caught in rips can't swim out of the pull, they should wave their arms in the air and draw plenty of attention to themselves. In Daytona Beach, Matt Lapoli, WESH.com.